Hey guys, Free Play Frank. Today I'm going to be showing you part one of my buzzsaw that I made to cut up firewood. Now I'm going to play one of my favorite songs from one of my favorite bands of all time, Burnin For You by Blue Oyster Cult. Now my shout-out tonight goes to Naked Extreme. Now this is another fabricating channel. He does welding, fabricating, machining. He builds lots of really cool machines. Built a firewood processor, a sandblaster, various other machines. He doesn't narrate his videos, so you just kind of have to watch. He shows everything he's doing, but he does a really, really good job. Really good video, really good channel. Check it out, you guys. All right, let's do this.
Okay, today we're going to be building a buzzsaw to cut firewood. So let's go over the materials list. Got a 16-inch saw blade, courtesy of my neighbor. 1-inch round stock steel shaft with a keyway at one end. Still got to buy two pillow block bearings. 9-horsepower Honda clone, courtesy of a friend. I've got a 3.5-inch pulley driving a 6.25-inch pulley, so that's going to give the blade about a 2000 RPM speed. We have a rear axle off of a minivan so I can move it around. And I'm going to be mounting it upside down to make it higher so it's at a comfortable work angle. We have a 55-inch long piece of 4-inch square tubing and a 2-inch trailer ball coupler so I can tow it around the yard. And this framework here is going to be mounted with the square part up, like it's sitting sideways right now. And I have a place to mount the blade, so the blade hangs off near the rear of this machine by the axle. And then behind the axle, I'm going to mount a bin. I have a way to put bins pallet made out of pallets or IPC totes, so the wood has some place to fall. And then on this side here, I'm going to have a V-shaped trough that's on hinges. And you lay the wood in the V-shaped trough and you push it through the blade, so that way my hands won't be anywhere near the blade. Should be safe to use. It'll be a heck of a lot easier than cutting it all with a skill saw. Alright, let's get started. Okay, now we got this part welded together here. See, I welded that long piece of channel onto this axle here. And then I attach that frame onto the trailer. And then I cut the end of it off and turn it upside down. You can see that this used to be extend back over here. So I cut this off and I cut 10 inches out of the angle iron here. Flip this upside down, give myself another 4 inches of height. And then that'll give a place to mount the pillow block for the shaft. And then I'm going to do the same with this end. I'm going to cut it off here. And then probably about somewhere here, but I have to determine that depending on where the motor ends up being. I'll come back and show you that when I get that far. Okay, let's mount the blade now. Okay, so what I've done is I've got two pillow blocks on this shaft. And there's the larger pulleys at this end of the shaft. And what I've done to mount the blade is I threaded the end of the shaft. And then I made up a spacer. You can see the spacer here because the blade and these pieces here, these two pieces that hold the blade, are 5 thou bigger than 1 inch. And the thread is about 40 thou smaller than 1 inch. So I made this little spacer here that takes up the difference, so these fit on there nice and tight. And this nut here is at the back so that you can tighten the blade, and I tighten this all the way up to the end of the shaft and then put it in the lathe and machine down part of this nut, about 3/8 of the nut. And I had to make this other little spacer here. So the blade is going to fit in this space here, and then this nut is going to tighten it. So we got the nuts and bolts here. So now let's take this over to the frame. you can see on the frame here, I've drilled 2 half-inch holes here with the mag drill. So now we're gonna attach this to these 2 holes, and then we're gonna locate where the rear holes have to go. So you drop the 2 nuts through here. As usual, I can't do it with one hand holding the camera, so we get these 2 bolts into here, and then that'll locate. Then we can tell where we have to make this part. I got lots of extra angle iron that I cut off this 4-inch angle iron frame here. I don't need all the extra. So I'm gonna make a perch for the rear mount out of this. And I'll come back and show you what that looks like. Okay, she's on. I'll show you how we did it here. Just use that angle iron and a couple pieces of flat bar to make the rear mount. Excuse me while I trip on everything. Then I braced it on the inside. Turns nice and smooth. And as I was clamping it and tacking it together, I kept turning it to make sure that nothing warps and goes out of straight. Spins real nice and easy. Got a bit of run out on the blade, not too bad, considering it's been hanging in my neighbor's wall for 40 years. Alright, next thing we're going to do is we're going to mount the table that the wood sits on. So I have this piece of steel here, and it's hanging from the engine hoist. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get it in here, and I'm going to line it up so it's parallel to the shaft and 90 degrees to the blade. That way when you push the wood into it, the blade doesn't bind. And then we're going to attach it down here at the bottom on this shaft. I have this shaft. It's not a shaft, it's a pipe with 2 pieces of slightly larger pipe that are going to be the pivot points for the table. And then this shaft, I'm going to fabricate brackets to mount it to the frame. And to do the brackets, I'm going to use these pieces of angle iron. So I'll get some of the pieces made, and then I'll show you what that looks like. So in order to get the shaft mounts lined up straight, I had it clamped to this heavy piece of angle iron at both ends. So I got this part for where the wood's gonna lay, and we feed it through the saw. And I've got it hanging from the engine hoist, supported roughly in the position where it's gonna go. And then I've cut these 2 pieces of angle iron to fit at roughly the right spacing. And then I'm gonna face off these 2 round pieces I made at the bottom on the lathe so that I can weld something to the steel here to stop it from sliding back and forth. And then I need to make 2 pieces of steel to come from here up to there, 12 inches long roughly. And then I have the short pieces I cut off from these, so I'm going to put in here for bracing. It works quite well. Now what do they do with my square? Square to the blade this way, and square to the blade that way. And then what I did down here was, to get it in the right position, I just used these wedge blocks of wood and I tapped them under until it leveled out. And I got these 2-inch by 1/4-inch brackets, angle iron brackets, to hold up each end. You can see I put a diagonal brace in there. I'm going to put another one at this end too, but I have to mount the motor first, so I got to make sure that fits. Plus I put a diagonal in here to stop the table from doing this, so I don't have to worry about it hitting the blade. All right. I also added this piece here, I cut the end off of this, and then I use 1-inch by 1/4-inch flat bar to fabricate these parts here. And this allows so that when you cut through the wood, so that it doesn't bind as the saw is cutting through the last bit of the wood. Plus it'll help it fall farther into the bins, because the bins are going to be mounted out here. So the next thing I have to do is, there's nothing to stop it from coming too far away, so I'm going to have to put some type of a mechanism to hold it so that it only comes out this far.
I'm burning for you. Okay, that was Burnin For You off Blue Oyster Cult's 1981 album, Fire of Unknown Origin. An even better live version is on the Extraterrestrial Live album from 1982. Pick 'em up, guys. And thanks for joining me, and we'll see you next week. Take care.